All right, we are good to go. Welcome, Amy, to another episode of Five Questions. How are you doing today?
I'm doing well, thank you. How are you?
I am awesome, as always. And Amy, you are in, I think you said Ohio?
I am in Cleveland, Ohio.
Awesome, good. And you got your five questions lined up?
I do. Awesome. I mean, I don't have five questions, but it's there.
Well, we'll see what comes through. We'll get us through as much as we can in about 20 minutes.
Okay,
and sounds maybe good. Maybe your cat will come up with some questions too. He's sitting next to you there. He wants to participate.
Yeah, this is the good one.
All right. What do you got for me first?
Okay. So I've been studying law of attraction for quite a while and I have made significant, I'm much further in such a better place than I was. So that's great. And I'm very good at focusing on that. But I seem to get stuck in, I don't know what to do. I'm not young. I don't know where to go sometimes with my life. I'm a server, a bartender. I have had a great job, but I never felt good enough to make big money, to do things I really wanted. And I'm not sure. I did the belief tree and I feel lighter, but there's still something stuck. And it's not good enough.
Okay. So there's a couple of things that kind of stand out there. So one of the first things you said is, I don't know where to go with my life. Mm-hmm. And I would say, you know, whenever I hear that from somebody, it's always about kind of taking a step back to realize that everybody really just wants the same thing, right? Mm. So as Abraham Hicks says, you know, every desire that we desire, the reason we want that thing is because of how we believe that thing is going to make us feel, right?
Right.
And if you were experiencing a life of constant and consistent happiness and pleasure, would it matter where you were or what you were doing or what your life looked like as long as you were really happy all the time?
No.
So what most people end up doing is they don't realize or recognize that happiness is pleasure is what they really want, right?
Right.
We are programmed to automatically think that we need to reach for something and to grasp onto something and manifest something to find that level of pleasure. So that's a great first question to establish this reminder for everybody that's watching and yourself that what you really want is pleasure and happiness. So that's a good reminder to take a step back and refocus on, instead of trying to figure out what a life of pleasure and happiness looks like that I can achieve, stepping back and finding that happiness, pleasure in the day to day. So in one of the collective live calls, one of the members came on, and this was somebody who'd manifested millions. They were running a $1 million real estate business and they had lost it all. And this guy, he was seeking pleasure in the big things. And he said, Nick, now that I'm not experiencing the big things, it's very hard for me to find pleasure. Now, the good news is it doesn't matter where you're at. If you can find little things to practice choosing to tune into pleasure with, then that's going to activate more pleasure in your vibration. The end result of that is going to be more pleasure in your physical reality, right? Mm-hmm. So my advice to everybody for seeking more happiness, more pleasure, which is what you really want, is finding pleasure in the small things, finding pleasure in your cup of coffee. Right? Finding pleasure in going for a massage, finding pleasure in your comfy bed and your pillow when you wake up in the morning. If you can take the time to find the pleasure in the small things and bask in the pleasure, then the bigger things and the clarity of what you want to experience next is almost going to start to begin to find you because you're practicing those vibrations of pleasure. Does that make sense?
Yes. And on the last call that you did, the collective call, really got, I really started thinking about it. This quarantine has actually been really good for me. And I've started to take pleasure in things that I haven't done for a long time. But So I've always been an artist of sorts, and I've really been painting a lot. And I sold 7 paintings. I've never sold that many. Amazing. This month.
Yeah.
3 have gone through. And so, you know, as an artist, that's how it goes. Yeah. But I get excitement about that and I feel good. And then I go back and go, I'm not really that good. I don't know.
Okay.
I got lucky.
Okay. So the reason you've been selling these paintings is because my guess is COVID-19 is forcing people to slow down.
Yes.
And, good. And when you slow down, what happens? You get in the receiving mode, right? Mm. Because people, when you're go, 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 that's energy out, energy out, energy out, energy out. A lot of the times it's through effort, right?
Right.
The
right.
receiving mode, you want to have a good balance of energy out and energy in. Most people are barely getting in the receiving mode ever, and they're not allowing that energy in, right? The receiving mode. So this COVID-19, what it's doing is it's forcing people to stay at home. It's forcing people to slow down. And for those people who are studying things like law of attraction and are finding joy in this process of being at home and finding ways to be happy, even if you're in quarantine, that slowing down effect is putting you more in the receiving mode, so you're letting more in. Mm. And the more you can practice that, especially from that vantage point of feeling good and pleasure, the more you're going to let in. Now, if you're letting in that much while practicing this piece of resistance of I'm not good enough, then if you can let go of that I'm not good enough, momentum's going to pick up even more.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah. And I know I've been a little bit sloppy and I have your book. I was reading your book and I think something just clicked listening to you, listening to Abraham, that really getting an alignment hasn't been, it's important to me. I think I do it, but having that commitment that I have now, but God, I beat myself up.
Yes, stop it. Do you think your inner being beats you up?
And, you know, and I've had great things happen, but, you know, I start to take score and I just go, oh, you know, when something good happens, I heard you say, and I've heard Abraham say, it's your inner being is showing you this, is guiding you. And I listen to that guidance and I get something, but I feel weird taking credit for it. And when someone goes, oh, that was a great job, I feel like a fraud. Like I didn't do anything because
Okay.
I guess that.
Okay. And do you want to maybe explore that a little bit and explore? Yeah. So, you know, what are we looking to do exactly? Is it clearing the belief of not good enough? Is it clearing the doubt? What do you think is that big piece of resistance that's holding you back?
I think it's that I'm not good enough to, almost like I'm not good at adulting. Okay. I'm real good at, you know, being a kid, but then as an adult, that gives me resistance because that's, you know, that's not how I'm supposed to be.
Okay. So that's an interesting concept. So what does that mean to be not good at adulting?
What does that mean to me? It means I don't have the steady job. I don't have the great income. I feel like I should be further in life. But in the same hand, these past couple of weeks, I felt really good. But there's still just something in there.
Okay.
I don't know.
Okay, so that feeling, we can't even give a label to that feeling right now, right? So if we ask that probing question on that feeling, right? So I feel that way because what pops in your head?
I'm not smart enough.
Okay, so you've got this belief that you're not smart enough.
I do.
0 to 10, how strong is that belief?
Oh, it used to be a 10. It's not a 10 anymore. I'd say a 7 or an 8. 7.
Okay. And I believe that I'm not smart enough because?
Because I don't know what to do. I've never had that single passion to do something. Okay. I feel not smart enough because...
But here's the thing. It's not your job to figure it out. Your only job is to follow your impulses, right? And here's something else on top of that. So, you know, at one point in time, you were sitting around in the non-physical like everybody else. And you were like, you know what? I am going to go down and play in physical reality and go hang out for a lifetime on planet Earth. And your inner being was like, okay, let's do it. And then your inner being and you co-creationally decided exactly who Amy was going to be, exactly what she was going to look like, exactly what her personality was going to be, exactly what her sense of humor was going to be. Every piece of who you are was molded by you and your inner being. Okay? So your inner being and source is infinitely intelligent, yes?
Yes.
Unconditionally loving, yes?
Yes.
They would never make a mistake, agreed?
I agree. What if I chose to have contrast my whole life?
Well, I mean, we've all chosen that, right? Because we're all experiencing it.
Yes.
But here's the point that I'm getting at. Your inner being would never create a version of you, and this goes for everybody, that would not be good enough, not be smart enough, or not be worthy, or any of those beliefs. Your inner being would literally never create a version of you that's not smart enough.
Yeah.
Do you agree with that?
Yeah, I do.
Good. So that feeling that was a seven, the seven belief of I'm not smart enough, does that feel gone now? Does that feel a lot lower?
I feel lighter, but yeah, maybe. It feels a little better.
Good. Okay. And give it some time to process and remind yourself that your inner being would never create a version of you that's not smart enough. Never. And if you're not where you want to be, it just means the journey's not over yet.
Right.
Right? Your only path is to follow your impulses from that place of alignment that your inner being is giving you. That's it. That's our only job.
Yeah.
Right?
No, I think I get it, and I just don't practice it.
That's a very good point, and that's something that a lot of people are doing. A lot of people are, you know, reading the books, watching the videos. They got a lot of head knowledge up here. But there's a big, big difference between understanding the concepts and implementing the concepts. And that's why something like that Power Manifesting Collective is so important, because that's where we help people week after week to apply the concepts and work through their blocks and continue to move forward. And it's a great reminder for everybody to make alignment a priority, because right now, law of attraction is speeding up. Manifestation is speeding up. Everything is happening quicker and quicker. So people need to start making alignment and vibration as high of a priority as they are, you know, the foods they eat, the exercise that they get. People need to understand and make these things a priority, because the quality of your life literally depends on it.
Yeah. Yeah. And just thinking the past couple of weeks, you know, it doesn't matter how many videos I listen to you or Abraham about meditation, if I'm not doing the meditation. And I really, I see a difference in the past couple of weeks. I just think I need to, I've heard you say, like, you have to, it's a muscle.
Yeah. And you're already on the right track. You're seeing the evidence a little bit now with your paintings.
I am. Awesome. I think it's just,
So pat yourself on the back. Good. All right. Throw another question at me.
Okay. And maybe I'm starting, it's funny that you feel lighter in one area and then I feel lighter in another area.
Yeah. So because everything's connected.
Yeah. I've wrestled with feeling guilty.
Okay.
A long time. That is slowly starting to go away. When stuff slowly starts to go away, is it my job just to now focus on something else? I feel guilty about things I shouldn't feel guilty about.
Okay, so we'll explore guilt, but your job is to always focus on what feels good, right?
That's it.
That's it. But, you know, if something wants to surface, if something wants to come up, if you have an experience that triggers guilt, you still want to acknowledge that emotion, because that emotion is your guidance system. It's trying to tell you something, right? It's trying to tell you about a perspective you're practicing. And that's why that belief tree process is so important. Because then you want to use that process to identify, okay, what's this perspective I'm choosing that's pulling me out of alignment, so you can then shift it and release it and let it go, so that it's not creating wobble and anchoring you out of alignment anymore.
Yeah.
Right? A lot of people have this belief that, you know, when a negative emotion surfaces, you should ignore it and turn away from it. And it's much more powerful to say, okay, what is this trying to tell me about me, so that I can shift that belief and release it once and for all, so that physical reality will no longer reflect the circumstance that triggers that emotion back to me. So let's talk about guilt.
Yeah.
So for you, how strong is that guilty feeling? We'll use this belief tree process.
Okay. So I'm going to say that the past few weeks past few months, that guilty feeling, I have started to release it. So I'm going to say I'm about a 5 in the middle of the road. I do tend to tug of war on things. And I think that comes down to being committed to this too.
Okay.
Because I feel that getting better. I feel not tug of warring so much. But sure.
So first, let's use that probing question again. First thing that pops in your head, I feel guilty because...
I probably did something wrong. I don't know.
Okay. So I did something wrong. Okay. Do you think out of the 7 billion people on the planet, there is somebody on this planet that never in their whole life have they done something wrong?
No.
So should everybody on the planet be walking around in this constant state of guilt?
No. And I'm a really pretty damn nice person. So I don't think it comes from an old childhood, something that happened that I felt so guilty about. And I can, if I see the same circumstance on someone else, I think, oh my God, well, that's nothing to do with you. So why I keep putting it on myself?
Yeah. And that's good awareness to have, because whenever another circumstance triggers an old emotion, it means that you've still got that emotion kicking around in your emotional baggage somewhere. So that's a good thing to recognize. So you're very self-aware, but you want to let that go, because if that's kicking around in your emotional baggage all the time, that's impacting, you know, your ability to find easy alignment. So we want to deal with that.
Yeah.
So would your inner being want you to feel guilty?
No.
No, of course not. And, no. You know, you mentioned, you know, something happened as a child that brought up that feeling of guilt. So do you remember how old you were at the time?
I'm going to guesstimate I was in maybe second grade.
Okay. So maybe like 6?
Yeah. 6, 7.
Okay.
Yeah.
So what a 6, 7-year-old, should they know everything?
No.
Are they busy learning, growing, expanding as part of their life experience?
Yeah.
And sometimes these life experiences involve learning things through contrast and things that maybe after the fact we realize wasn't the best idea.
Yeah.
And is it okay to learn in that way?
It is, absolutely.
And did that 6 or 7-year-old, after they experienced that circumstance that they felt guilty about, did they keep doing it, or did they learn their lesson from it?
Well, it was something that happened to me, which is why I don't even get what, because I can look and I think when I say it out loud, I realize how stupid it sounds and I don't.
Good.
Yeah.
So can you acknowledge right here, right now, that this guilty belief, this belief that I should feel guilty, doesn't make sense?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Let that really anchor in, that belief that it doesn't make sense.
Yeah.
And can you show?
It just came off my heart.
Good. And can you show that 6, 7-year-old that explained to her in your mind that feeling guilty for this doesn't make sense, and give her permission to let that go?
I think I can. Yeah. Awesome.
Good. And do you feel lighter now?
I do.
Awesome.
Yeah.
Good. So we've taken care of the guilt. Let's squeeze in one more question. Can you throw one more question at me?
Well, I think you kind of answered my question. Well, with the guilt, I think the guilt stems from two. I always felt fake because as a kid, I put up barriers. I'm great. People always said, you know, told my parents, oh, you're, you know, I'm very acclimated to where I'm at. But that was my defense mechanism. So I've always felt like a fraud. But when you said that about guilt, now I see that was, I can let that go too, because yeah. I'm not a fraud, but I felt that way
for a long time.
Yeah. And it was just a defense mechanism, right?
Yeah.
You were doing the best that you knew how based on your level of awareness at that time, just like anybody else.
Right. Yeah. It kind of alleviated that at the same time.
Awesome. Awesome. And that's a testimony to how, you know, all of our emotions are all connected. And that's why we call it the belief tree process, because that belief tree process allows us to work through all those layers and break those connections to release more and more stuff. And if anybody's curious about the process, chapter 5 in my book, Power Manifesting, and we got a lot of videos on it in the collective.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. I think my biggest thing with listening to you is the energy going out, just getting into that receiving mode and just really making this my morning practice. It can be my daily practice at this point since I'm not going anywhere.
Totally. Totally. And again, it's such a great reminder for everybody that, you know, the quality of your physical well-being is dependent on, you know, what you eat and your exercise, and the quality of your physical reality is a reflection of your alignment and the vibrations that you practice.
Yeah. I get a lot of stomach aches, and it's funny. I just realized, like, wow, I don't have a stomach ache at all right now. In the mornings, this is early for me.
Yeah.
It must be associated with that.
Always is.
Holding it in.
Awesome. Thank you so much, Amy.
Thank you, Nick. I really appreciate it.
Awesome. And we'll see you on the Collective Live calls on Tuesday.
Yes, you will.
Awesome.
Yes.
Great. Well, you have a good day.
You too. Thank you.
Bye.